What's up, guys, and welcome back to Let's Play Dark Souls Kita Edition! Alright, let's go ahead and do this thing. So, let me make sure all my settings are correct. And I've been informed by, I believe, Brent Ramstein to suggest that I should go into the pit next, and then I have some affirmations to that, that's what I should do. So that's what I'm going to go ahead and do. And I hate to say this yet again, but again, I am sorry, guys, for the delay. As you can see, the settings I'm fixing right here are because of working on lore video stuff. And also, I had a big audition that I don't know if I'm allowed to talk about or not. I don't know if I got it yet, but I had to prepare for that and do stuff for that. So that was pretty important for hosting-related stuff. Anyways, if we want to go into the pit, we need to get some stuff from Shalquar. No, my name's Dave Shalquar, come on.
You do have a rather pleasant scent.
Okay, so her thing about this pleasant scent,
I'm quite
the more souls you acquire, the more she talks about your scent becoming better and better and richer and richer. And by souls, I mean like if you open the Shrine of Winter, which would indicate you have a lot of souls, you all of a sudden your scent smells even better. So I think she can kind of sense when you have a lot of souls on you, which makes you seem even more and more likely to be the one who's going to go ahead and link the fire. So that's kind of what she's referring to. Now, I know I don't have enough money to buy anything. I just want to see how much I need. Silver Cat Ring is 1340, so I need 10,000 more
nothing.
Souls.
Well, that's...
No, because you're trying to, like, cheat me out of buying things, Shalquar. Okay, let's go ahead and use some souls. We can drop a Proud Knight Soul. I'll hit that. Ooh, wait, that's not nearly enough. I'm gonna have to hit one of these babies. Brave Warrior Soul. That's not enough either. That's not... I thought I had more of these things collected. Okay, there we go. That's enough.
Oh.
Come on, Shalquar. Stop joking with me. I can't take a joke. Okay. So, let's go ahead and buy the Silver Cat Ring. So what this is going to do is, Silver Ring depicting a leaping feline reduces damage while from falling. That's the important one. Legend has it when the cats grow old, a force brews within them, and they're reborn as something new. Huh. Okay. I'm not sure what that something
satisfied?
New is. But maybe
I'll
that's why
around.
She's like, yeah, you gather them souls, and then I'll be reborn with the cycle that's going on. So we could talk to Laddersmith Gilligan and have him make some ladders for us, and that'll help us with some fall damage, but I think you still need the ring anyways, so just to go ahead and ignore him. I don't need you, I just wanted you, if that makes sense, Gilligan. Silver Cat Ring. So, we can go ahead and drop in here, like I said, without his help. So, here we go. Boo! So it's close death, but we still survive. Now, you actually can stack with, like, fall control and things like that. You can stack it pretty well. So, eventually, you take pretty much no damage dropping in here. And then there's also the feline, like, boots you can get that also add fall immunity. But, yeah, it's something you can stack. Ferris Lockstone, so that's always important. Let's keep on falling down. A lot of people didn't make this jump, apparently. This is the jump I'm referring to. Or they could have just died another way. I guess I could have checked that out. How they died. Okay, so I think this is the one where we have a choice. Yeah, so here we could either fall to the right down there. Although maybe it's better to jump from that one. Or we can do what I'm about to do, which is falling here. Let's see. Yeah, I don't think you really want to jump. Oh, wait, there's a dude who's about to try. Ghost, what? They might have died. I don't know. But I think you can actually survive that drop there, and then you can go down even deeper. But bear in mind where that ladder goes to. That's actually a locked, sealed door. I think this episode we're going to be able to get the key to that door. So bear that one in mind. And there's actually, you can completely skip the Grave of Saints here. It is an entirely skippable area. So that's also an important thing to note. So now that we're at Harvel's resting place, not to be confused with Havel. I do wonder if they did that on purpose, because you find Havel's gear right around here. Makes you wonder. Ooh, kinda makes you wonder. Kinda makes you... I don't have all the answers. Come on, guys. I have a lot of answers, but I don't have all of the answers. I try. I really try, but... This is a big game. So let's go ahead and continue forth. And if we get summoned, we get summoned. We're getting summoned! PvP! PvP! First PvP of the Let's Play. So, if I get summoned a lot, I will just do some quick cuts so you guys don't need to see the loading screen every single time. We'll see what happens, but yeah, like I said, this area is entirely skippable if you don't want to worry about getting summoned all the time in the people's worlds and all that. Yeah. So. Hello! Hooray! Hello! Even to nobody. Matt. Alright, let's just go ahead and deal with Hollows here. I don't know if my sword's up to snuff. Let me see what my running attack is. Running attack's gonna be a stab attack. Alright. So I say take it cautious and slow if you get him summoned as a Gray Spirit. Because you never know when the person's gonna try and come for you. So, let's see. Yeah. Anyways, take it cautious, take it slow. And that way when he does come for you, you don't have to deal with the fact that there's like rats and that person trying to run at you and take advantage of the fact that you're getting attacked like you just did. Okay. Oh crap, what just killed me? That guy! That was terrible! Worst job on my part ever. I should have taken those guys out first. I didn't realize I was trapped on them. Wah, wah, wah. Oh well. It's okay. He got me. Fair and square. I guess. Alright. Anyways, it's not really a big deal. It's not like I lost anything, so it's like, who cares? Alright, good for him. That's kind of what I like about the Rat Covenant. I think it's fun to go into someone's world. And I don't know, I love the Rat Covenant. You don't lose anything for getting it summoned into the person's world. So it's like, if they die, it's their own bad, you know? You as the person getting summoned, it's not your fault. So I like that aspect of it. And I just think it's a fun covenant to be in too, like trying to create traps for people and all that. It's just a really good covenant. It's definitely my favorite new covenant of the game. I don't know. Who actually does Bellkeeper Covenant and enjoys it? I've heard people do it, but I haven't heard anyone say like, wow, I love the Bellkeeper Covenant. That one's sure is great, guys. Alright, so notice all these Ferris Lockstones here. For the most part, unless you're part of the Covenant, they really don't matter. Except for a few of them. So this would be one of those few. And I always like dropping this one for if I join the Rat Bros anyways. But most of them are for traps. Like this one right here, I believe, lights up some torches, if I remember correctly. Small, smooth, and silky stone. And then like this one over here, this just opens a little pathway behind there. So a lot of them are really for the Covenant. Alright, let's get some poison moss. And that's what I'm saying, like this is one of the few ones that actually does matter. It's because it'll open up a little area here. Plus, I actually enjoy having this one opened up for when I am a rat bro. You know what I'm saying? And I'll explain why, other than the fact that it's awesome. Whisper of Despair. Yeah, so it allows you to get the Whisper of Despair. Let's go ahead and take a look at that one. Sorcery. The Whisper of Despair. A hex that releases verbose darkness. The darkness echoes words of despair, reducing the defense of opponents. The dark blank is the world in black, a thing of tranquility and a thing serene. So, yeah, you can also open up that top area up there, but I don't like to. I like to just open up this bottom one here so people will try to run away and go through it and realize it's a dead end. Ha ha ha, that's what I like to do. So, if you're playing in offline mode, at this point, this is where we would be invaded by Roy the Explorer, and that's where we could get his set. And I'm wondering if that's like a... if that's kind of a note from the developers in a sense, like kind of their little joke. Since there's two versions of his set, Roy's set. One of them is the coward version where you can see through it. And one of them is the non-coward version where you can see it. The non-coward version you get in New Game Plus from Black Phantom. And New Game Plus Plus and etc. etc. This version where you that's transparent, you have to be playing in offline mode. So it's kind of funny that in order to get the one for offline mode, In a way, you're kind of being called the coward. There's another way to get the full set, like coward set, though, without playing online, which I will show off at a later time. It's from Molin. Yeah. I think you have to have 0 souls from Molin. I'm pretty sure that's what it is. So, anyways, I'm pretty sure, again, all of these other Ferris Lockstones in this specific area are just traps. Just don't waste your Ferris Lockstones. I mean, unless you're playing this Covenant, then go ahead and do what you like. So this is, oh, there we go. I was like, this is supposed to be a boss fog gate here. I'm not sure why it's not there, and there it is. There it is! Where's my rats? What's up, rats? Oh, I thought it'd be a one-hit kill. I really want to level up this sword a little bit more. I need to get my level up stuff here. Some more Titanite. I think I was still on large Titanite shards, right? Or am I at the trunks now? Anyways, we gotta start making so this is a blade to be feared. When that people are like, oh my god, that black steel katana is the scariest thing I've ever encountered in my life. Rats will tremble at the sight of my black steel katana because it's a downward swing, perfect for dealing with rats. They're like, what is this madness? It actually is perfect for hitting us creatures that are low on the ground. Ah! Get out of here, rats. Oh, rats. Oh, crap. Oh, hello, boss one. Yeah, you can, I mean, if you guys haven't figured it out, which I'm sure you have. If you haven't figured out, the Royal Rat Vanguard is the one who has a mohawk. So, there you go. That's the way to tell them apart. The one that has a mohawk is clearly the badass one. I mean, obviously. That's like 90s 101. Alright, where are you, mohawk? What the funk? Where is the mohawk? I don't care about you other ones. We just need to deal with mohawk. Like rat. Oh, there he is. Hello, mohawk. One more hit, and they will all run away. So, get out of here, rats! Get out of here! Royal Rat Vanguard Soul, and we get our first rat tail, which is, you need one rat tail in order to join the Rat Covenant. So, let's look at our Royal Rat Vanguard Soul. Royal Rat Vanguard Soul. The Rat King's loyal servants judge the worthiness of those who seek royal audience. So, you have to prove yourself in battle to the Rat King!
Leave this place, human.
I don't want to.
We have no time for thy kind.
I'm different, I swear.
Humans bring nothing but filth.
Well, look at you. You're all blood-faced, and you're saying that. Blood-faced rat!
Is that a rat tail, human?
Yeah, it is. What of it? What of it?
First one of mine rat burrows conquered. This will not go unnoticed.
What, you wanna fight? You wanna fight?
Rejoice, for the right to serve me is now thine.
Okay, cool.
Since thou art human still, permit me ask, wilt thou thy human soul surrender and pledge thyself to me? Swearest thou by the sweet-tempered sludge that laps at our bosoms?
Join the most badass covenant in the game? I am a rap bro! Rap bros for life!
Thou hast the eyes of one who perceiveth true beauty.
You're beautiful. I want to kiss your face.
Human, thou mayst serve. Take this ring. It was forged by a human who was once among us.
Crescent
the ring
rat.
Draws to thee those who would defile our burrow. Wear the ring whenever thou art near, and destroy those who would dare provoke our ire. I will grant unto thee all thou should so desire. I prithee serve with a true rat's honor. Speak thy mind, servant.
Okay, so, for being part of the Covenant, A, to level up in the Covenant, you have to offer him rat tails, but you can buy his various goods, which is always, like, some corrosive stuff, which is fun to throw at enemies. corrosive urns. Which, by the way, interesting lore on that. Giant anthills created by the corrosive ants line the horizon of the desert land of Jugo. Ant larvae are considered a delicacy, but he who enters an anthill uninvited will have their flesh melted to the bone. But again, land of Jugo, this is where we get a lot of lore on Jugo. And the fact that the corrosive ants and all, basically, I think all the corrosive materials come from Jugo. So, and we do meet a corrosive ant further down in this area. But
my servant.
The important thing about this covenant is not only do you get the rat tails from defeating foes while you're in the covenant and beating them, you also get an even more important thing, which would be you get Ferris Lockstones. So if you're like, oh my god, I need more Ferris Lockstones, I wasted them or I want them, this is how you get them. So what I'm going to do right now is I'm going to unequip my Gold Coveted Serpent Ring plus one, because I don't need that. And I'm going to equip the Rat King Covenant. Rest of the Rat. So I'm going to do a little bit of PvP. So I'm going to go ahead and quick cut here so you guys don't have to just sit around waiting for my PvP. And yeah, let's go ahead and do first PvPs of Dark Souls 2. Even though I already had that one that did not go well, but quiet. I was ill-prepared. See you guys soon. Okay, that was really quick. I don't think I'm even gonna do the cut. A man is lurking near. So I reset the bonfire so all the rats would be alive again. At least I'm pretty sure I sat at the bonfire. So all the rats should be alive, and when this guy gets summoned, I'm gonna be a giant asshole, because that's what the covenant's about. Okay, murky plains. Okay, so what I like doing is I like hiding behind this spot here, and you kind of have a couple opportunities. You can run out with the rats as they come to him, or you can kind of sneak up behind him. Okay, apparently I'm an idiot and all the rats are dead. Oh no, there they are. There they go. So, this is again where you can decide how you want to play. So do you want to be an asshole, like I'm about to be right here, and make sure you have to deal with a couple things at once? Which is kind of what I'm doing. I don't like this weapon for PvP. Okay. Meaning to smack his crap away, but kind of missing a bunch on that. Alright, you roll really slow, bro. No! Alright, whatever, I stunned him. Works for me! I don't do much damage at all. Alright, and let's go ahead and stab. You're not gonna get in your health. Oh, you actually did? Okay. I don't do any damage at all. This guy's not playing too well, is he? Murky Plains. Murky Plains, please. I need to get better at doing this one thing I keep on meaning to do. Ha! My rat got him in the end! Bye-bye! Thanks for coming to my world. Ferris Lockstone and the rat tail. So there you go, Ferris Lockstone. Alright, this time I actually will be back. Come to my world. I've been practicing smacking in the face. Oh wait, that one I messed up. Smack in the face. Spinning smack in the Ooh, not a total spinning smack in the face. There we go. So prepped and prepared to smack in the face. Okay, so I switched to the Hay Knight Sword. To see if that lightning damage helps me tackle people a little bit better. I'm used to using the Mudakumo, so that's kind of the weapon, I don't know, I'm just in general, that's what I'm used to for PvP. So these new weapons are just that, they're new to me. So, what strategy to utilize for this guy? Will my brethren help me out? Find out on this episode of PvP. Okay, my brethren have left, and let's decide what to do here. Alright, he's taking out my rat brethren pretty well. So, let's go ahead and actually open up another spot that I like. Use up one of our fairest lockstones here. And we'll have another area that we can kind of, wait a second. Oh, damn it. Okay. Well, if we want to use lightning, now we can, I suppose. For some reason, I thought that's where the little cove was. Where is this guy, anyways? Where are you? Hello, Zaxxari. I grow tired of waiting for you. Alright. So apparently he's going for range. But he's slow. Sorry, bro. I hate the backstab. I'm actually not a big fan of the backstabs, but, you know. Yeah, you thought. That's the funny thing about backstabbing now, is you can actually get stunned from a failed backstab. Alright. We gotta get these smacks in a little bit better. Ah, well, didn't need it. Welcome to my world. Goodbye. Bye-bye. I shall be back. As I wish... I don't want that waterfall. Oh, well. See you guys soon. Yes! Richard! Oh, this guy's a caster, I see. We'll have to let him come. Think have him come to us is the way. Eh, whatever. Screw it. I'll be dumb. Goodbye! Hello! Goodbye! Yep. Let's call it rolling through an attack, buddy. Goodbye. Bye-bye. Wah! Ferris Lockstone and Rat Tail. Time to reset and start all over again. Welcome to Kita Zone. Wow, that sounds terrible. That sounds like a ball pit place. Welcome to Kita Zone. It's a ball pit fun land. It's like Jungle Gym. At Kita Zone, we have ball pits. We have a foam pit for people who want to jump on trampolines. We have tons of slides, because that's Kita Zone. Kita Zone! Yeah, that taunt didn't work like I thought it would. Ha ha ha. What's up, guys? My name is Kita. My rats. Go forth. Ooh, this guy's got a bunch of... Alright, so he's a faith guy. Actually, probably gonna use... Definitely going to use the fact that there's water to his advantage here. So, with that said, no water for me. Ha ha. I have other areas that I can hang out at. Like this spot right here. I wonder if he'll see me. Hello. Goodbye. I will use my wall. Because I'm not going to go into your fun zone. I got all day, buddy. This feels very unhonorable. But I know that he wants to lure me into the water so he can throw lightning bolts at me. I'm not gonna let him do that, so... You can do what you want, man. I'm not gonna go in there. Sorry. Dude, it's not the fact that you cleared out the rats. I'd face you one-on-one. I'm just not stupid. Okay, waste all your lightning. I'm okay with that. Oh, he's probably fighting off the rats. Okay, good to know. What's up, buddy? Hi. Welcome to the Rapro Hell! Yep. Bye-bye! Welcome to hell. I'm an asshole, I know. Peace! Alright guys, sad news. I've been sitting around waiting for an invasion for like 10 minutes. Not an invasion, the Gray Spirit. And I'm running out of hard drive space, so I'm gonna just have to move forward. And we'll come back at some point and do more PvP. Maybe in the other part of the Rapro Covenant area. But I'm gonna do another quick cut. Fast travel to Majula, do some leveling up, and we'll be right back. So, 1, 2, 3, that's it, okay. Cool, we get some, let's do dex and agility, or adaptability so we can get agility. And that'll be it. Alright guys, just wanted you to see what I'm leveling up, and we'll be back in no time. As much as I love you, Rat King, we're gonna have to switch out rings. And go to this creepy thing right here. Nice way to allude that you're gonna have to drop down when you see the skeleton bones hanging there. Alright, let's go ahead and re-equip the rat ring, or the silver cat ring. I don't think you actually need it for this part, but it's just kinda nice to have. Alright, we want to make sure we don't fall in the hole in the wrong spot. Grab another Ferris Lockstone. We got so many now. I'm so stocked up on Ferris Lockstones, it's brilliant. Yeah, even if you don't, I don't know who wouldn't like the Rat Covenant, but even if you don't like it, it's kind of good just to do to get a couple lockstones at least, and then move on. I mean, if you don't like it, you're kind of just crazy. I can't help you. Can't help you if you can't do it, if you don't like it. I've never been able to get that jump. I think you actually do have to jump for that item right there. I've never been able to get it. I'm just being straight up honest with you guys. Never been able to pull that one off. Okay, so see right down there, that area, that's actually where that other shortcut's gonna lead to if you want to, oops, missed you. Oh well. Oh well, anyways, up here, this is, well, I can just show you. Let's go ahead and show this off. So say you want to just completely skip that area, you don't want to worry about the boss, you don't want to worry about being summoned into other people's worlds, you can just drop down further and you'll eventually end up, and see right up there, where I'm looking at? You can see that's one of those ledges. This is the pit. So further down, this is the bottom drop ledge that you can drop on. Well, sorry about that, guys. For some reason, my capture device signal just got screwed up. So anyways, let's continue forth, shall we? Hey, buddy, who just dropped onto my head. Yeah, so as I was saying, I really haven't figured out how to get that one before. Or yet, I should say. So if you guys know, go ahead and write in the comments. I appreciate it! Alright, so then we're just gonna drop down here and let these guys come to us one at a time. They're so kind to do that for us. Okay, cool. One hit will kill. Just had to make sure. So yeah, as long as you just like let them kindly come to you one at a time, it's not too big of a deal. You just take them out like this. And even though it kind of is an ambush, it's not a very well planned ambush on their part. They should have just tried to ambush you six at a time, then they'd be rocking. Grab that charcoal pine resin. I actually didn't know they dropped that. I'm still learning new things. And with that, since we grab a great heal, pretty much wraps up this area. Great heal, I don't think there's any lore really. Only a select few have learned to recite this epic romance in its entirety, but those who do are amply rewarded. But, I mean, it's good to know where it is, especially if you guys are faith builds. Good stuff to know. Alright. I think what happened was, now that I'm starting to play through for real, the game capture device was like, this has to be a separate file. I can't register this unless it's a separate file. Otherwise, it makes no sense to me. That's what I think happened. Oh shit, 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 no, no! Oh, I cannot believe I survived that. I've made that mistake before and died. Good thing I was wearing the silver cat ring, huh? Yeah, it was because I was running. Alright, let's see if I can find the ladder back up. Unless there is no ladder back up. Oh yeah, you just dropped down. Well, hopefully I didn't miss anything important up there. I forgot if there was an item or not. Attack just in case. And I didn't think it was a mimic. Token of Spite. Okay, so this Token of Spite is what's going to allow you to join the Covenant of Blood without doing any PvP. Let me look at this item. I can show it off. Token of Spite. Token. So Token Fidelity is so you can join the Blue Sentinels. Token of Spite, you can join the Covenant of Blood. So, normally you get that for invading someone's game and killing them, but this will allow you to actually join the Covenant as long as you have one. These things are assholes, and I'm sure you guys who have played in the gutter know that. These things are the worst things ever, because they love to spew poison at your face. So, what we do is take them out. Take them all out, I say. These things suck! Oh, ow. Get your poison away from me. Alright. Let's see. If I drop down there, that should be good. Yeah, you don't want to drop over there. It's actually, I think, a dead-end spot. Now, what you can do is try to drop over there. There's a wraparound way to do it, but you can also just try to drop it. Oh, wait, this is going to fall. Oh, well. It all worked out in the end. Bonfire lit. So remember all those torches that I've been gathering for my one singular torch, I should say. That's going to really come in handy now, as you can see one person doing it. Let's show off those lighting effects. How much time do I have left on my torch? An hour and 19 minutes. Crap, I'm gonna run out. I'm just kidding. So I like to try to light all of them. Not that it does anything, but kinda, it's nice, I don't know. You can start to see the area lit up when you start doing that. And also, if you're trying to like work your way around and figure out what areas you've been to and haven't been to here, it's a good way to tell. So yeah, we're not going to be able to get here yet from this spot. I don't think you can jump up there, and I'm not going to risk it. Alright, there's another trap over here. I forgot which platform it is, though. Which platform is the trap platform? I don't remember. Okay, we got through. Yeah, you have to walk across over here to actually get there. So that's what we're going to do. Hopefully I can not sneak up on this guy and screw that one up. Alright, let's try to roll around him. Smack him in the ass. No! No! One more attack. One more attack. Okay, there we go. Whew. That is not playing that well. The swings were pretty wild there. Light the way to indicate that I've been here before, just for myself. Oh, get out of my face. Do not poison me. So I could drop down there. I don't remember if this is like a shortcut or not, but we're gonna just continue this way. Because I think this is the actual wraparound. I hate these little poison-spewing dudes. Been a little while since I've really explored the gutter. I did that on my first playthrough, and that was it. Because I didn't really need to do it any other playthrough. Anyways, let's keep on wrapping around. Oh, that's kind of... I didn't notice that. One of those things is hanging there. It's supposed to be an image of a saint, I think. But I'm not sure what saint it is. That's something I'm still trying to figure out. Oh, jeez. That guy just did a lot of damage on me. You jerk, I say. I like these little sludge towers there. I think those are pretty cool. Anyways, knock that thing out. Yeah, so this is what we're going to want to eventually jump onto, is that ledge over there. Get out of here, thing. Will I be able to do it like that? Yep, there we go. Ha ha ha. You can't hit me. I will not let you poison me. Roll! And let's take out these guys before they can do any damage to us. Again, usually I have the Murakumo when I come here, so it's a little easier to just, like, knock these guys out with some massive damage, but that's okay. That's okay. Alright, so, really this is kind of like indicating, like, okay, where you really want to go here is just drop down. There's going to be a little ambush here, so let's make sure to take out these guys before they can really ambush us. Okay. You guys kind of got me there. Not happy about that one. Now this guy could have messed me up, because he actually had a blade. Anyways, take out these things before they do some real damage. And there you go. So this is kind of the easy way. You can also do a leaping jump from that platform, the upper part of that platform, onto here. And I've done that before, but this is the easy way to get over here. Let's go ahead and light this one. And don't worry, guys. Okay, so I know in the last video I missed a lot of the treasure chests and all that. I will go back and get them. I'm sorry. When I go back to fight the Smelter Demon, I will get those. That was just my mistake. I screwed up. I don't know why I forgot to get that treasure chest I kept on messing up opening. But yeah, as soon as I go do Smelter Demon, I will open it. I promise. I swear. Let's drop down here. And I don't think there's any real reason to go into this part of the ledge, but I'm going to do it anyways. Okay, yeah, because I can't even hurt that guy. We'll worry about climbing up in a moment. Get out of here! Get out of here! I got torches to light, yo! Torches. I got... I guess it's sort of a torch. I got things to light. Honestly, I don't know much lore to this area yet. I know that this is where people kind of just throw things that are unwanted, and a lot of undead just kind of got tossed down here. Like, I think it was just a, oh, well, let's accidentally kick this guy into the bottom of a pit. And since they're undead, they don't die. They just come back and just hollow out here. Yeah, so this is, I forgot about that little statue. I don't think there's anything you can jump to from here, like any platforms or anything. Take care of this guy. So you can do this though, and this is kind of what the wraparound's for, is to get this chest. Okay, so it's got a handle on the side. I'm still trying to figure out the difference. The front part looks kind of dirty and rusted, but it's still got that big handle on the side. But you can get the Ring of Soul Protection, which we'll look at in a second. That was created by either Ivory Rones or her students. Ivory Rones being from Lindelt. Well, let's look at this. This is actually a pretty good ring. Oh, you know what? We'll look at it later, because we got Melinda the Butcher. You guys remember Melinda the Butcher, by chance? Dark Souls reference? Not only is it a Dark Souls reference, it's also a Demon Souls reference. Oh, crap. I pressed Y instead of trying to dodge it. Oh, I cannot believe I died to Melinda the Butcher. That's just sad. That is just sad. Wow. Alright, guys, I'll be right back. Alright, guys. Right now, I'm going to try to get Melinda back, but I just realized there's a treasure chest that I missed. So I'm also going to try to get that. I'm honestly not sure how to get it, so maybe if I run. Looks like if I run here. Oh, cool. Okay, here we go. Treasure chest. I don't think I've ever gotten in this before. I never knew about this. So, sometimes it helps to have your lights off. Twinkling Titanite and small and smooth and silky stones. That was a good one. Twinkling Titanite. Now I can level up my Dringlake mail. Make that even stronger. You know what I'm saying? Alright, so there's some more stuff here. Well, I guess it's a good thing I died. Because I was able to find that stuff that I'd never found before. Alright, and let's go ahead and get Melinda back. I missed that jump, but it worked out okay. Come back, Melinda. Come back. Oh, it's because I'm not human. Wait, never mind. So yeah, Melinda gets summoned up there. Alright, Melinda. Oh, shit, really? I'm going to try and use the fact that Melinda gets stunned. Alright, Melinda. Not going to have any of it this time. Crap, why are there no new guys coming to attack me? Where'd they come from? Okay. Let's take care of Hollow, dude. So he doesn't bother me. And then we can take care of Melinda. She's got no armor, so she shouldn't be too bad to take out. Stunlock. Melinda has been banished! Goodbye, Melinda. Bye-bye! Go to hell. Ha ha. Okay, anyways, let's go ahead and light my torch. So this is gonna lead us back to the beginning, this area right here. So let's go ahead and do that. Now, we can get a life gem, and as you can see, I am back. Here we go, right back at the bonfire. The bonfire, if you would, if you will. God, I've had so many recording mess ups now. Like, the recording itself screwing up. I'm honestly not sure how long I've been playing. Okay, there was a trap. Well, now if I ever go back, I'll know where it is. So that's good, at least. I just wanted to light the torch. I think that's where they get you. You're like, I'm gonna go light the torch that I see. And then you get struck. Struck by a trap. Anyways, it doesn't matter. It's a whole nother path here that I wanted to check out. Go to anyways. Well, we'll light the one down here at least. This one we will light. And then we will go forth. And check out the bottom area here. Oh yeah, here we go. Gotta make this jump. I was like forgetting. So I'm like, where do I go again? So, there's a bunch of stuff that you're going to want to remember in this area. Namely, that there's another area to use a key. So that key I was talking about before, that you could use by dropping down into the well. There's a little area with a key. There's another area over here with the key as well. So keep that in mind. And yeah, this is the area. So see right over there? I'm not going to be able to open that yet. But just keep in mind and remember that spot. Because as soon as we get key later on, which is going to be in the Black Gulch, you want to come there. And I think that's actually where Havel's armor set is in that one. And the one beforehand was a bunch of armor and such. Yeah, the key actually is a really important key. It's got a lot of good stuff to it. As well as the Pilgrims of the Abyss. Do some more stuff with that. What is that red thing on the wall? Oh, I guess it's just a blanket. So I guess you could just drop down here. Right. Okay, thanks for setting that trap off for me. But that's okay, we'll drop down to this one and work our way around. Because there's no reason to do either. It didn't really matter, it looks like. Make sure you do get this, the Dark Pyromancy Flame. If you guys like pyro stuff, you might be interested in this one. Which I will show off and say, how did that guy hit me? Seriously, how did he hit me with that? I thought I rolled past it. Anyways, we'll show off the pyromancy in just a moment. First, I gotta clear out some hollows, if you know what I'm saying. Hollows always get in the way. Come on, hollows. What are you guys thinking? What are you doing? Okay. Let's light this one up. And good thing I saw you. I was about to go check that item. Alright, so let's look at the... Oh, never mind. I should really just clear, get to the top level first, it looks like. Alright, we'll keep climbing up for the time being. Alright. I forgot to see what that was, but it's okay. So, we're gonna get this one, and then eventually we're gonna want to drop down onto that platform right there. That's gonna be our goal. But before I do that, let's go ahead and look at the Dark Pyromancy Flame, because this gets kind of interesting. It's going to be in Catalyst. Wherever that is. Where are the Catalysts at? There we go. A flame catalyst used by Pyromancers. The flame rewards those with a thirst for power. The more hallowed one is, the stronger its effect. So the spell power scales with hallowing. So that's kind of an interesting new take. So it actually makes it so you do have a benefit for being hallowed out with that one. I've really tested compared to the other Pyromancy Flame because I just haven't been playing with attunement slots really. How much better it is than the other one, or if the other one's better once you level up enough. I'm really honestly not sure. But just an interesting different one I wanted to point out. Alright, let's go ahead and lure this guy over here. Take out these things first, they don't poison me. Just want some more space. Oh no, he tried to attack me and he missed. Oh no, he tried to attack me and he missed again. Oh. Oh god. Okay, this isn't going well for me. Let's do this. Oh crap. Crap. More hollows. Okay. And maybe one more will do it. Nope. One more on top of the one more will do it. Yeah, those guys can do a lot of damage. That's why I'm being cautious with them. But those fools. Alright, there we go. Now we've cleared this area off to go upstairs and light another torch. That's all I wanted. I just wanted to light another torch. I'm gonna light this place up, baby! This one's not a mimic, but eh, I'll check it. I almost didn't check it, that's why I was saying it like that. Black fire bombs! Not the best thing in the world, but still a thing. Still a thing. Alright, let's go ahead and drop down here. And... I think that's everything in this little spot, so we'll cross the bridge. Cross the first bridge. Or first kind of bridge. Of a many, many, many bridges. Jeff Bridges. I always forget. I know that I think there's a bunch of secrets in this spot. Yeah, see those guys? You can just see that ambush waiting. That's where I was before, but you can see how many of those guys are just waiting to ambush you. Now again, there's another way you can get over there than the one that I took, but that's just an easy way to see just how many of those dudes there are. Alright, now that we're up here. So yeah, one way you can do is you can literally run and jump off the ledge here, and you can make it over there. So that's another option available to you. Light up this torch, and I've already been there, so we'll cross another bridge. Huzzah! Alright, so for this one I always forget which the right way is. I guess it's just the other bridge. Never mind, that's easy. Yeah, you drop down there, or over in that spot right there, that's where we're gonna eventually end up. Or we can drop down over there. Let's cross the bridge first, though. Check out over here. It might just be to a cave. Yeah, it looks like it's just to a cave. Oh. Alright. I kind of forgot about this cave. I'm glad I found it again. Take out all these hollows. Yeah, this area really... It's more about exploration for this area. I don't find it particularly that hard. You just need to explore. And be cautious. The Wicked Eye Great Shield. Let's look at it. The Wicked Eye Great Shield. Okay. This is one of the ones that won the shield contest, actually. The true origins of this shield is unknown. No amounts of polishing can clear its face of the mysterious handprint. Effects HP absorb. But yeah, I think the most interesting note about this one is it did win. It's one of the shield contest design winners for when From Software had people submit in shields to end up in Dark Souls 2. So we could drop down here, or we could work our way around and drop down into that center area over there, where the dog was. I don't remember, like, we could just drop right back down here. I'm not sure what the benefit of dropping down to this dog is, honestly. I mean, I know that that's the way to the bonfire is over to the right there. I do kind of wonder, though. Well, there's an item there, so I guess suppose I'll get it. Possibly be really dumb. We'll find out. Was this the worst mistake ever? We shall know very soon. Well, that guy wasn't tough. Let's find out what the item is. Was it worth it? Black fire bombs. No, it wasn't. But I had to know. I had to know. It was very important to me. Alright. So, okay. I guess all that does is it's just another path. This one's a little bit more of a difficult path, since you gotta deal with those spewing assholes. Let's see if there's a ladder up. That'd be nice. That'd be very nice. Doesn't look like it. Okay, I guess we're gonna get poisoned. And let's just get a little running start here for this area. Alright, there we go. Huh, alright. Managed to- Oh! Oh! I was like, I managed to avoid getting poisoned, and then I got hit by a bunch of those things. Alright. Whatever. Whatever! We're close enough to a bonfire, it doesn't matter. It don't matter. It don't matter at all. But I'm not gonna let myself die. Alright, let's light this baby up. So we got our second bonfire here. And I have no idea what I'm like on time right now because of all the messages, which is kind of screwing me, but I do want to at least start the Black Gulch. So I'm going to at least start it. I probably won't fight the boss yet. Alright, this is where it is. Yeah. Don't think I'm going to fight the boss quite yet, but I do want to show off a cool little shortcut in the Black Gulch, just because I already recently found out about it. Really, I found out about it recently because of Lucatiel stuff that I was trying to do. I didn't find out about it until that, but it's one of the ways to open up Lucatiel for the fight. You have to talk to Lucatiel before any boss fight you can summon her at, before you can find her summon sign, which I think makes sense. I like taking out all the poison guys just because they need to get out of my way. No? Know what I'm saying? You guys don't deserve to exist. Get out of here, saint. You're no saint of mine. Saint of poison. I don't like the saints of poison. Alright, well, we'll go through the boss or the fog gate on the other end, so. Here's the other end of that fog gate that you saw we could have dropped to before from up here. That's where we could have dropped down to from. And it looks like we got one of these guys here. Alright. Doing some nasty damage on me right away. Alright, and interesting lore thing right here to point out is that not these dudes right here. Actually, I'm going to take out two-handed. So these dudes right here are whatever, but this guy right here, this is actually a corrosive ant from Jugo. And the only way to find that out is by looking at the Dark Souls 2 strategy guide, because that's what its name is the corrosive ant. But this is actually a corrosive ant from Jugo. It's the only one in the game. I don't think that white spew that's spewing out is actually poisonous. And you don't get anything I know of for killing it, so after my first playthrough finding out that for killing it you got nothing, I kind of just leave it alone. It's not really doing anything, it's just hanging out there. So we'll leave it alone. You will live another day. Live to fight another day. I have no qualms with you. Except for all the corrosive pots that we're about to have to go run through. But other than that, I have no qualms with you, corrosive ant. See if there's anything over on this edge. I don't think there is, because there isn't. Alright, so even again in this spot, there's gonna be more little areas for us to, there's a whole bunch of areas to explore here. So you kind of want to check out all the little ladders. I don't remember which ones are better than the other ones and all that, to be perfectly frank, as there are a lot of options here. There's a lot of options here. So it's hard to keep track of which ones are good and which ones are pointless. This one looks like a pointless one. Oh, and what do you know, it's a drop-off. Alright, well, with that, then I suppose we will keep on going down and we'll come back up. Which I might do quick cuts for depending on how long it takes. Get out of here! You can't even handle me! Oh crap! Oh no! Well, that's gonna be a quick cut. Well, I'm not happy about that turn of events. But, eh, it's okay. We can deal. We can deal. So, mainly because I already killed all these little saint statue things. Come on. Oh crap! Oh, come on! Let's take care of these hollows. Your stupid cursed black darkness swords. Okay. I think that's enough of them. Well, that was dumb. Oh well. It's just 19,000 souls. It ain't no big deal. Not like that 40,000 I lost all the time. So, let's keep on at least checking out more spots, because that other one I went to wasn't that important, as it turned out. So this one, I think, yeah, I could drop onto that ledge if I wanted to, but there's no reason to. So, what we're gonna do is go over to that ledge over there, because there's actually stuff on that side. So many options, so many ladders, so little time. That sounded like it. A hollow came to say hello. What's up? When you guys climb up ladders like this, I appreciate it, because I can just take you out this way. Alright, we have yet another option available to us. I thought this was the way to drop down. Oh, here we go. Alright. And there you go. So here's one of those, one of the little ledges you can get something from. Rotten pine resin, which, that one's always a fun one. That one's always fun. And here's another one. Okay, that didn't work. And what we're gonna want to do with this one is drop down to get the treasure chest, so. Just one of many. For the Great Club. Let's take a look at it. Great Club, where are you? Designed to smash foes, simple but terribly effective. From what I hear, this is a really, really good weapon. Maybe possibly even OP for strength builds. See, that's got B scaling there. It's really, really strong, and I think it actually scales. It might scale better, too, once you level it up. So from what I hear, that's a really good strength-based weapon, if that's your build. So, might want to bear that one in mind. Let's not get murdered by these guys this time. That would be the simple goal. Very, very simple goal. Alright. That one will help. Yeah, I just have to be a little more cautious, and things are okay when you actually take your time in Dark Souls, as they constantly try to teach you. So only corrosive urns are those ones right there. Ooh, Dark Fog. Let's go ahead and take a look at that. So many items. So many items. Dark Fog. Dark Fog is another hex, and this one is regarded as a poison due to the outward symptoms, but in fact, the mist eats away at the target's inner essence, just the trace that led to the prohibition of hexing. So hexing, like dark magic in Dark Souls 1, is really looked down upon. People aren't fans of it. People aren't fans of it unless you're Falcon the Outcast. Wow, that's a lot of life gems. 20 life gems from that. Alright, let's figure out which one of these is going to be good, and I might have to do some quick cuts here. As I climb up ladders, we shall see. Okay, this is gonna lead us to the inner base, which I wanted to get to. So this might have been the right choice. Or no, it doesn't matter at all. Okay. So those are both just gonna lead us up to the top. Well, there's an area I wanted to check out at the top anyway, so let's go to the top again. I'm really just worried about my hard drive space, honestly, with how long some of this stuff is taking. Alright, I wanted to check, where's my bonfire at? Here we go. I did want to check over here, because this is kind of like a little nook that's only open this way. Yeah. Alright, let's check out this corner. Could be good, could be nothing. Well, at least it leads us to nothing. Except, oh, okay, so that other one's gonna lead us to a pot, and this one we could drop off down onto that platform, which has nothing, it looks like. So we'll go to the other one. Sorry, I got not much to talk about here. I think the channel update video I'm working on is gonna go up before this, but I'm working on a 10,000 subscriber channel update, which is, honestly, it's just crazy. Just madness, really. Alright, let's check up here. What about this ledge? Do ye hold anything? Ledge? Nope. Nothing. Except for another way up. Okay, another pointless ledge. But yeah, thank you guys so much, man. On the 10,000 subscribers. That's amazing. I never... When I started this channel, I never thought that would happen. I never thought I would make a popular YouTube channel, really. So thank you guys from the bottom of my heart. I never saw it coming. As I keep on repeating myself, but it's true, and I've set up my seventh, when I got like 7,000 subscribers, but my first like real channel update video. That is just something I just never expecting to get. So, yeah, I mean, I put a lot of work into it, the channel and the videos that I make, so I really do appreciate it. And that people recognize that. But you never know, I mean, it's just that YouTube, it's so oversaturated at this point, really. I mean, it's a great platform to getting started and showing off yourself, and anyone can build themselves up, but it's just so oversaturated at this point. It's really hard to get noticed. So that's why I say, like, I never thought it would happen. It's not that I don't, you know, I was like, yeah, I want to make good videos, I want to make good content, but just never thought I'd get noticed, like I said, in the vast majority of how much stuff is out there. That's where the black fire bombs are gonna come in handy. Right there. That's actually the first time I've tried black fire bombs against that. Before I always just used a, you know, kind of a waste of black fire bombs, but eh, whatever. I don't wanna have to deal with the corrosion. Another fragment branch of yore! We got all sorts. We got so many fragment branches of yore to use now. Anyways, this is gonna lead us to the black gulch. I think that was everything I was saying about the YouTube channel, so just how everything's just so oversaturated now with so many things, and it's just hard to get noticed, really. Really hard to get noticed, even if you're making quality content. Alright, so let's go ahead and get our first Black Gulch bonfire. And I'm going to show off this little ledge that I want to show where Lucatiel's at, and that's going to wrap me up. Because I think I've gone over quite a bit with the PvP and combo of everything. So, I'm not going to deal with these guys just yet. You know, should, but eh. Okay. So I think this right here is the ledge that you can drop down on. Let me extinguish that. Or maybe this one is. Oh, here it is. You can just barely see it there. Barely. But here's a ledge. Well, once again, the video got messed up. So, gonna have to think about how I cut this. Anyways, let's go ahead and talk to Lucatiel. Might have to go old school and make it be a forever compression.
Still on the road, are you? Sorry to have burdened you so. This is for you, by way of an apology.
Thanks, Lucatiel. Ring of Steel Protection plus one!
I found my thoughts growing hazy. My memories are fading. Oldest first.
So again, there's that theme of as you go hollow, it's in...
Curse is doing its work upon me.
Yeah, you just kind of like forget who you are.
I am frightened.
Where you were from.
Terribly so. If everything should fade, what will be left of me?
I don't know, but I can summon you now.
I had an older brother. We learned to fence together.
Was his name Aslatiel by chance?
He became the most decorated swordsman in all of Myra. I never even compared to him.
But, Lucatiel, you're so good against Smelter Demon.
Not once.
I joke.
Then, one day, he was gone. Lost without a trace. Now I'm certain that he was taken by the curse.
Yeah, I'm just about positive that Aslatiel is her brother. I think it's just cemented in my mind. Correlation. Aslatiel's a dark spirit who invades you in Aldia's manor.
If only someone would hear my tale. My brother must have come here, too. Soon I may forget even about him. If only someone...
So that's gonna wrap her up, but now that we've talked to her, we can actually summon her, and that's definitely something you're gonna want to do. So yeah, I guess if you see, like, signs up here, that's what will help you know if you're playing online that you can go up here, but this is how you get up to this little ledge up here. That you may have noticed before but not known how to get to, is through this. So that is how you do that. Get out of here. Don't poison me. I hate you poison things. I hate you so bad. Oh, you suck. Poison things suck so much. Alright. Let's go ahead and take this guy out, I suppose. Well, since I'm already kind of over here, I guess I'm just gonna go... Now that I've already used this shortcut, scraps a light torch. Take advantage of the fact that I'm already poisoned. You guys can't poison me because I'm already poisoned. That one, however, can. Okay. Let's heal up. Yeah, so as long as you don't get in front of these guys, you're not going to get hurt by them. Like those ones right there. So just let them pop out, and then you can deal with them really easily. So another area that I got to show, because it's also where you summon Lucatiel at. Let's take care of these things. Take care of these things first. And I know I missed the cave. I will go back and get it. I know. I'm just running out of time. Actually, I always like to try and lure these guys out. Because that grab, if you're right next to them, they will get you. Oh, crap. I didn't think you were... How did you get me again? Man, that was not a good fight on my part against those dudes. Those guys are really good for dropping. They drop Titanite chunks, and they drop large Titanite shards. So you guys know. So actually, let me make sure my gold coveted servant ring plus one is equipped. It's not, so let's equip it. Just in case. Why am I only getting one hit and it's stopping? I don't understand what's going on. Anyways, I really gotta wrap this up. So, if I missed any items, I know, I'm sorry, I will go back and finish up Black Gulch on the next playthrough. If we are human, this is actually going to be where at Lucatiel 77. So, that wraps me up. Thank you guys so much for joining me. And I hope you guys enjoyed some PvP. I hope you guys enjoyed this episode. And next time, we'll wrap up the Black Gulch and head to a new area. Let me know what you guys want to see next. So, see you next time. Later, guys. Peace.